Teachers Day special at the World Auto Forum. Friends, every guru, every expert was once a beginner. So friends, we have a lot to thank to our gurus and mentors and teachers. So we have brought together the finest leaders of the automotive and the mobility industry, and let's find out what they have to say about their gurus and teachers and mentors. And like each time, I'm playing the backbencher, so I'll come right at the end. So you have to wait for my video, and when you do that, you've seen all the other gurus and all the other leaders talk about their gurus and teachers. So friends, see you in a while, and happy Teachers Day.
Thank you, Anuji, for inviting me to share my experience on this Teachers Day. Namaskar. I would like to share an incident, you know, in my early career, which was in 1976, when the then manager accounts of our company and was, you know, asked me to go to Calcutta to collect the about 3 lakhs rupees as a target money, but I could come back with 1.5 lakh rupees, and he did not allow me to come to the office, and he asked me to go back and collect the balance 1.5. As a son of the owner, I was very upset, but my father really taught me and motivated me again to go back. And I went back and I brought more than 1.5, almost 2.5 next time. So this is the instance, and he was a great teacher in teaching me accounting, in teaching me target setting, in teaching me adherence to the target. And this taught me the perseverance, patience, and achieving the target. I owe him the best. Thank you very much. Namaskar.
Guru is the one who teaches you maximum in your life, and the teachings or whatever you learn carries you throughout your life. I would say my parents have been my first teachers, and the values and the ideas which they have enshrined in my personality have taken me through the life. My next best gurus have been the people of the country, those who have really gave me the flavor of the country. India has a extremely rich cultural heritage, the values and the variations, the diversity which it has, and that I picked up from the common man and the common citizen of the country. And let me tell you, the citizen of the country is extremely imbibed with the extremely high level of values and the intentions, and that has really given lot of strength to the country. And there is a lot to learn from the country, from its people, from its land, and from the various ecosystems of the country.
What we become in life is a matter of the opportunities we get and the gurus and teachers who influence us in our lives. My life has been no different. My first teachers and gurus were my parents. They provided the foundation characteristics: respect for others even if they have a different viewpoint, play fair even if you lose a game or two, work hard. My next guru was Dr. Charitram, chairman of the Shriram Group, a hard taskmaster. He taught me the value of integrity. He also taught me that investment with the best ROI is investment in good people. He often said, even though people are shown as an expense in the balance sheet, they are the true assets of an organization. But to be most effective, people have to be supported with systems and procedures and discipline. I was only 22 years when he made me the divisional manager of Usha International to manage 50 employees. He believed the best place to learn is the marketplace, when you rub shoulders with customers, and you have to learn in the deep end of the pool. My newest gurus are my children. They have taught me, work hard, but don't forget to have fun, and do it now.
If there's one thing my teachers taught me, it is to know the difference between getting a degree and having an education. Education is a lifelong learning. It's almost as if you're running on a treadmill, learning just to be in the same place. And once you've started learning, you realize the importance of sharing. Sharing your knowledge, sharing your experience. In other words, becoming a teacher yourself. Happy Teachers Day.
My greetings on Teachers Day. My primary guru, my teacher from my childhood has been my father, Mr. Jaswant Singh Sanghi. I think whatever I am today, whatever I embody today is from his teachings, from his guidance and from his inspiration. From the word go, he taught me the value of relationships, the value of being honest, transparent, hardworking, the value for never giving up, the value for leading your team from the front, the value for being a part of the team and not the leader of the team. Whatever I am today is from his teachings, from his blessings. Everybody who comes into your life, though, is your teacher. Whether it's your friends, your family, your colleagues, your entire team, you learn something new, something good from each one of them. My greetings to each one who has come in my life and has been my teacher. Thank you and all the best.
I've been lucky to be coached and mentored by some great professionals over the years. They've all played a very important part in my development, but the most important learning that I've got working under them is the amount of trust and confidence that they had in me and giving me responsibilities even at times when I wasn't ready. All they did was stood behind me, watch me commit mistakes and learn from them. I try and practice the same with the people that I work with because I truly believe trust and confidence can go a long way in shaping up somebody's career and influencing them on the right way.
Greetings to everyone on the Teachers' Day. Our teachers, our mentors play a huge role in shaping our career. For most of us, our parents should be our first teachers and mentors. Let me just share with you some learning from my father. He always said, honesty, integrity, and hard work really pays you in life a lot. He also was a firm believer that we need to educate kids a lot. So focus on education was there. So as I was graduating out of my master's, so one of my teachers said, don't think that just because you are becoming a postgraduate today, it's end of your learning. Think that it's actually the beginning of your learning. As you start your next phase in life, always try to use each day as a learning experience. As I got into the job, one of my colleagues, he gave a good thought which I always remember in life. He said, if you have to be successful in life, when you come to office in the morning, keep your ego at home. You need to be humble at all times. I think humility really plays a huge role in success of each individual. And finally, the fourth one which I want to share is, when I was over here at Hero, our late chairman emeritus, he said that treat each individual in the organization as your family member. And if you really treat them as your family member, they'll treat you as family member. I think some of these learnings always remain with you. And that's which plays a huge role in your own growth, both personal growth and professional growth. Wishing each one of you Happy Teachers Day once again, and thanking all my teachers, mentors, colleagues, everyone from whom I have learned a lot in my life. Thank you very much.
Hi everybody. I would like to thank the World Auto Forum for inviting me and asking me to share my experiences. I think this is a very opportune time for all of us to recognize, remember, and really appreciate the role gurus have played in our lives. I think the way they have shaped our lives is something we don't appreciate as much. And today I would like to talk about two such gurus. First being my father, the way he has taught me to understand the ground realities of any business before entering that business and really connecting with the gamba, which is going to the shop floor. So that is how he planned that, how I got trained in different companies across Europe and India. I think that has been instrumental to making me what I am, and definitely really seeing that how people from different cultures, backgrounds and perspectives really work together. So dining with them, staying with them and really working with them in that culture, in that moment, really makes you a different person altogether. So I can never thank him enough for this. Similarly, I think it's very important for any person to strike the right balance in life. So how to have the right work-life balance. So my mother has been extremely instrumental in playing that role, that how I have had that right work-life balance, because only with this you are able to grow and you are sustainable in your life. And definitely you look at your parents as your idols for doing everything, but I think both my parents in different ways have really made me who I am today, and that has been my foundation as a person. So I really thank them, and I really see that everybody has such gurus in life, how we can understand, appreciate and really take all their teachings, learnings and put them together to really set the right foundation path for each one of us. Thank you, and a very happy Teacher's Day.
Hi, I'm Manjari Chaudhary. On this Teacher's Day, I'm reminded of two very important learnings from my professional gurus. The first was that learn to take feedback constructively, evolve and continue to grow each day. And the second most important thing was that while you do great work and you should be good at what you do, do not forget that people management plays a huge role in anybody's success. The world is all about people, and managing them is key to success. I thank them for their wonderful learnings, and I continue to work on them each day. And here's wishing all our gurus and our professional mentors a happy Teacher's Day.
Hello friends, I would like to take this platform as an opportunity to thank each one of you who have been teaching and inspiring me in every walk of my life. I will pay my gratitude to all my teachers, including my parents and family. And not to forget, World Odo Forum, they've always been evolving the best out of me by the brilliant work they do. Thank you. Happy Teacher's Day.
On this Teacher's Day, I would like to thank my teachers, my professors and the professional gurus. My name is Dinesh Bhaseen, and I would like to say two things which I learned from these gurus in my life. The first one was from my school. One of the teachers said that I must be transparent and visible to the people as I am, should not deceive or cheat the people. And second thing which I learned from the professional gurus was that when you change the company, don't take the people who were working with you earlier. A true leader is the one who develops the people who are given to him, not the ones which have been working earlier with him. Thank you very much, and once again thanks to my teachers, the professional gurus.
Good morning friends, and wish you all a very happy Teacher's Day. It's such an important day. Everybody in life teaches us something, and I would like to take this opportunity to talk about three things that have been taught to me by various people in my life. I would not take names because it will be unfair to all the other people who taught me multiple things. So starting with something which my school teacher taught me, he told me as a half joke, Rajesh, hard work never killed anybody, but why take chances? In fact, what he told me was, there is no substitute for hard work. Intelligence, smartness can be substituted by hard work, but hard work cannot always be substituted by shortcuts or by intelligence or by smartness. And till date, I have believed in it. No matter what requires to be done, it is absolutely essential to give up 100% to it. Let me jump immediately to corporate life. So one of my very early bosses had told me that please use me like an umbrella, not as a stick. Which means please don't always keep looking at me for support. Try and be independent, do things by yourself. However, as an umbrella, I am always there above you to shield you from all kinds of rain, sunshine, bad weather which comes from the top. This is something which has stuck with me, and I try and use it as much as possible with my teams. And third and finally, this is interestingly was mentioned to me by one of my teachers as well as by one of my very super seniors early in my career. They said, Rajesh, you should always develop the capability to take one step back and look at the larger picture, the bigger picture. You know, we get so fixated on looking at the details which are important that we forget to look at the larger picture, which is what makes it much easier for us to decide the next step, decide the next course of action, or the any kind of countermeasure which is required to be taken. So I would like to go on and on. There are so many things that we learn. At my age, I can't even count them. but I would like to end my message with this. Once again, wish you all a very, very happy Teacher's Day, and my very sincere thanks to all my teachers and everybody who has taught me something or the other. And to everybody viewing, please stay healthy, stay safe, and bye-bye. Thank you very much.
On this Teacher's Day, I wish to express my sincere thanks to all my teachers and professors for helping me to achieve success in my academic goals. Special thanks to Sri Gomathinayagam and Sri Subramaniam, who were like starter motors in my academic journey. As far as professional learning is concerned, Mr. Majumdar was my first guru, who taught me about automobiles, dealer operation, service operation, etc. But who can forget Dr. Kumar, who was inspiration for all of us on product quality as well as for customer-centric service. At Hyundai, starting from Mr. V.D. Basin, my Korean guru Mr. H.S. Kwan, Mr. B. Mani, all my directors and managing directors, they gave a lot of opportunity for learning on management, operation enhancement, productivity, efficiency, etc. But Mr. D.S. Jang, my Korean guru, he injected the dose for early part of digitalization. But as you grow older, you have to learn more, not from individuals. So I learned from the entire organization, the entire changing environment, and colleagues, friends, customers. So learning keeps continuing. Thank you.
Life is a great teacher in itself, but along its journey, you meet people who have the ability to summarize its teachings and pass them on to you. I've been lucky to have met quite a few such people along my life's journey, and Teacher's Day is a great opportunity for me to remember them and express gratitude for their contributions. Early in my career, I got to know one such personality whom I consider my professional guru. The two guru mantras that have since then influenced me have been, number one, always try to attract as much work as possible to yourself. That is the only way you will have new things to do and learn. And if you do all that work well, a definitely better chance to grow. The second teaching which I've imbibed from him was, he taught me responsibility and ownership. His favorite line, and now mine, is, if you make a mistake the first time, I forgive you, since it was your first time and maybe you didn't know how to do it well. The second time you make the same mistake, I will still forgive you, because maybe I didn't teach you well. But the third time you make the same mistake, I will kill you. Yeah, how true. With this, on this Teacher's Day, I bow my head to and say thanks to all the teachers, colleagues, and seniors who have taken interest in my development and shared with me their life's learnings. Thank you.
Life is a roller coaster, and 2020, we've really had our fair share of a rough ride. It's at times like this that you remember all the teachings, all the learnings, and all the guidance that you receive from your teachers, from your professors, and from your mentors. I've had a really interesting career, and I wanted to take this Teacher's Day to thank all of you, and you know who you are, and there are many of you who've helped me understand, who've helped me to form myself into a professional which is able to be resilient and agile. Thank you. And I would like to take your message and your guidance and inspiration even further and do my bit too on this Teacher's Day. Thank you all, and wish you all the very best for 2020. Stay safe.
Teacher's Day, a day wherein we remember all our teachers, our gurus, and our guides. So I wish a very happy Teacher's Day to all my gurus who have been playing a very important role in starting my career. Amongst all the teachers, I would like to name Mr. Anurag Sangal, a person under whom I did my articleship training for the tax accountancy course. We very fondly call him Bhai Saab. Bhai Saab had, while we were doing our training, instilled a lot of values in us. One of the major values that he taught us was honesty and integrity. These two parameters I've been following all across my career, which is spanning over 25 years, and I have never forgotten these two words. Above that, he always said, hard work and perseverance makes a real good chartered accountant. Keeping these values in my domain, I have been able to perform my duties as a finance professional with a lot of aplomb, and I would like to thank Aisab for charting my career.
Hello everybody, on the Teachers Day 2020, when we all as a world community are going through one of the most crucial pandemic period, I would like to pray for well-being of all. On this day, I would like to salute and remember all my teachers and gurus, without whose guidance I would not have become the human being what I am today. The key message I have learned is, when you point one finger to others, you must realize that three fingers are pointing towards you. Means change yourself rather than blaming others or trying to change others, which will give you a lot of happiness and peace. Thank you.
My heartfelt gratitude to all my teachers and elders for their kind blessings and guidance. Thank you.
So friends, how did you find our top WAF gurus talk about their own gurus, teachers and mentors? Extremely emotional and actionable and straight from the heart. So friends, coming to my gurus and teachers and mentors, so friends, of course, parents have a huge role to play right from the beginning. So a lot of things that father has been telling us, they have stuck on. Things like, kabhi kisi ke saath galat mat karo, aur kabhi bhi kisi ko aapke saath bhi galat mat karne do. And mom always selflessly caring and promoting good education, because she has been a teacher herself, teaching experience of close to 50 years. In fact, I belong to a family of teachers. And talking about learnings, you know, it just happened. It was just serendipity. I had just bumped into a saint on the Rajdhani Express 20 years back, and I just casually asked him, what is the secret to a good life? I asked him and I just forgot that I had asked him this question. And the next morning when we reached Delhi, we were just about to disembark, he tapped on my shoulder and he said, Anuj, you had asked me a question, I have the answer. I thought all night, and the answer is Himmat or Vishwas. Frankly, I had even forgotten the question. But then these two words also have stuck on, Himmat or Vishwas. Courage and conviction and need of the hour, the things that we are going through right now, the challenging time, we need courage and conviction, we need Himmat or Vishwas, we need to be there for each other, we need to physically distance but socially be closer than ever before. So friends, stay safe, and thanks a ton for being with us for this Teachers Day special. And going by WAF's philosophy, now is the time to action these things, taking things from dialogue to action, the WAF way. Thank you, stay safe, cheers.